Hi everyone, this is Carlo, and today for the series Human Stories, I'm gonna get naked. Yep, bollocks out. I came across two interesting videos last week. One from the Try Guys, and another one from Elbat. The starting point for both was to draw their own nude self-portrait, and it turned out to be a chance to talk about self-esteem, body image and body positivity. I did a bit of research on the internet and I found an experiment of nude self-portrait in three steps. And I decided to try it, for you but also for me. I'm not sure how this video will be received. I tried to crop the image and not make it too revealing. I don't wanna be banned by YouTube. But I might have missed some bits, so I wanna apologize with my mom and dad in advance. This is not an art video. Although we're gonna draw, we're not gonna focus on someone's artistic abilities. But it's a chance to get reacquainted with our naked bodies, explore our relationship with them, and discuss about body confidence and other matters. Now, take pen and paper, sit back, and enjoy this experiment. Okay, so this is day one of the experiment. And we will do a little exercise just to break the ice. I'm gonna keep my clothes on for the time being, especially because it's very cold. For the first part of the exercise, we have 10 minutes to draw an image of our face for someone who hasn't met us yet that will summarize how we look like. So that will give an idea of how we look like to someone that hasn't met us yet. 10 minutes. It's not much time, but it's doable. Okay, I have my paper and my pencils, and I'm gonna try. Yeah. I don't know, I will start very loosely with some lines, maybe. Actually, in the ancient Greece, the canons of beauty of a face were pretty mathematical. There was a formula of symmetry and proportion between, I don't know, the size of the eyes, how much distance from an eye to another, where does the forehead start to consider someone beautiful, and something like that. Yeah, it was basically a celebration of symmetry, which is, at the end of the day, very, very far from the idea of a natural beauty. Where do I have them all? Is it this side? This side, yeah, so I think I flipped my face. No. So the eyes are definitely too big, and it's not very similar to what I am, but it is what it is. It's what I remember my face to be like done in 10 minutes. For the second part of this exercise, I'm gonna finally use the mirror. Desperately need a haircut. So, in the second part of the exercise, I must draw an accurate self-portrait of my face. The most accurate possible, showing all the visible moles, flaws, plenty. Be raw and true to what you see. What I think would be a little issue is that, of course, you have to look at yourself in the mirror for a long time, isn't it? And we're gonna start. Yeah. My ears have a bizarre shape. I think they're different. My face is a little bit chubbier now, after lockdown. So, I have a conflictual relationship with my nose. Overall, I don't dislike it, but every time I have to take a picture, I always go for this side of the face because it's straight. And I really don't like this side because it's more like a hook. Another issue that I've been dealing with lately with my face is my hairline. It's receding. I don't know how to feel about it really, because I would like to have the confidence to embrace baldness and just shave it off.
But I think that I still have to work on that kind of confidence, really.
Okay, this is the result of the second part of the exercise. I don't know how to feel about this again, because this exercise was more about observation of ourselves, and for sure highlighted my worries about getting old, about I'm gonna sleep on it. I will let you know everything at the end of this video. I'm ready for day number two tomorrow. I will take my kit off. Will be interesting. Top off. Done. I have to say that I feel much, much less nervous today. Yeah, I don't hate myself much today. This is great. So for day two, I have to identify one part of my body that I hate or I wanna change, and I have to draw it accurately. I already know what it is. This. It's this whole part. And my love handles, yeah. Especially now after lockdown. I mean, if we go back in time to the Italian Renaissance, we have these paintings with plumper bodies, and they were beautiful. I guess that around the 90s, things started to change in terms of canons of beauty, because with all the top models and the catwalks, we started to have this meter started leaning towards the dangerously slim for women. But not only for women, also for men. I mean, if we think about Calvin Klein, Guess, Abercrombie and Fitch, advertising with those muscly hunks, they started to impose a kind of a role model, which is you have to work out, get ripped, eat your body weight in protein. Not only for an ideal of beauty, but also for an ideal of what is healthy and fit. So you are healthy and fit if you are muscly, but not if you are a little bit overweight, you're not considered fit. Which is crazy if we think that in order to maintain that body, you have to constantly check that your body fat percentage is low. I don't think that I will mentally cope with that kind of lifestyle. It's not a question of being strong enough to. I don't think that I will be happy. Because I love my pizza, I love my carbs, I love my biscuits. That's it. I'm definitely liking this second day, because also this part of my body that I said that I hate it, at the end of the day, I don't hate it. It actually looks kind of cute when you draw it. And tomorrow is gonna be even better, because I'm gonna get completely naked. I feel very energized today. So, for day three, you have to draw your full body nude self-portrait, celebrating yourself and your naked body. Which means, guys, you can fluff it a bit. Not too much, just a bit. Our relationship with nudity depends much on our upbringing, how we were raised. When I was a kid, I grew up in a Catholic environment. At home, but mostly at school, I used to go to a Catholic school run by nuns. But yeah, I grew up in that environment with the idea of nudity as some kind of a sin, something that you have to keep hidden. At school, we used to have separate playgrounds for boys and for girls, separated by a fence with plants. And that's when I started questioning, is there a sinful nature that lies beneath? And is it connected with our naked bodies? That is why nudity seems so inappropriate. At the same time, I was seeing these beautiful paintings with religious scenes full of naked bodies. And I started asking myself, how can this be acceptable in that context? But it seems like a sin in real life. just be naked and free. And later on, I realized that the figures that were portrayed in those paintings were not sexualized. It was nudity, but it was not sexual. It was art. What made us sexualize nudity all the time and subsequently classify it as a sin? Is this wrong idea of nudity as something necessarily sexual the starting point of a series of body issues that an individual can have? For many people growing up, their naked body was a mystery, kind of an uncharted territory. I went on drawing for 1 hour, 1 hour and a half, and I had so much fun. I have lovely nipples. And I cannot wait to think about it and draw the conclusions of this experiment. It was actually great, I have to say. What have I learned from this? The first day was very insightful. Having to create an image of my face within a limited time frame and without a reference from a mirror made me draw an idealized picture that turned out to be not resemblant at all and made me question how much I actually know how I look like. My reaction to the second part of the day surprised me. I didn't expect to feel so uncomfortable having to study my face in the mirror. That close inspection triggered a mechanism of self-deprecation. Believe me, I edited out a lot of my remarks about my face. I ended up being very harsh with myself. Also, I realized how much I fear aging, now that my face starts showing the signs of time. So the first day, all in all, was kind of a reality check, a necessary, uncomfortable first step. And indeed, the following days went much, much better. I noticed that I quite enjoy being naked, and drawing the part of my body that I hate, my belly area, helped me make peace with it, and almost like it at the end. We discussed fitness and body image, and I want to clarify that I still think that it's important to keep healthy, eat properly, and stay active. But of course, we have to take into consideration our happiness too. And in general, make sure that every decision that we take for our bodies, we take it because it makes us feel better, not because of some image that the media pressure us into conforming with. I ended the experiment feeling really happy, and I realized that the human body is something beautiful that deserves to be celebrated, regardless of its shape, its type, the amount of muscles or curves. I definitely recommend this experiment, or we can call it a challenge if it sounds cooler, to all of you. For many of you, this will be the longest time that you've looked at yourself naked in a mirror. But I'm sure that after an initial awkwardness, you will have a lot of fun, you will learn a lot about yourself, and you will love yourself a little bit more. At least this is what happened to me. Now, before I show you my naked self-portrait, don't forget to subscribe my channel for videos about traveling, creativity, and human stories every week. Take care and see you soon. Ready?